Please note. The audio for this video was recorded with the help of an AI service offered by IBM. Please take help of the captions in case you miss out or face difficulties in understanding. Welcome back. In this online lesson, we will discuss a poem by Kamala titled An Introduction. In the upcoming class, we will discuss another poem by her, My Grandmother's House. Let's start off with a bit of background before we get to the poem. So, Kamala also known by her pen name, Madhavikuti, was an Indian English poet born in the year 1934. She also wrote short stories in Malayalam. Her work voices the pains and pressures of a typical Indian woman who is suffering behind the thick veil of conservative traditions and customs. Through her work, she asserts that women, including herself, are victims of sexual humiliation under the male domination. Her works nurture a ray of hope in the hearts of women suppressed under male domination. Some of her popular works include her 1976 autobiography, My Story, and her 1976 novel, Alphabet of Lust. Some of her celebrated collections of poetry are Summer in Calcutta, published in the year 1965, The Old Playhouse and Other Poems, published in the year 1973, and Only the Soul Knows How to Sing, published in the year 1996. Being confessional in nature, these books intrigue and fascinate curious readers. She was awarded the Poetry Award for the Asian Pen Anthology in 1964, the Kerala Sahitya Academy Award for the Best Collection of Short Stories in Malayalam, and the Chaman Lal Award for Fearless Journalism. Interestingly, Susan Guber and Sandra Gilbert considered her as the only representative from Asia for their Norton Anthology of Literature by Women. Instead of going line by line, we will try to focus more on the important points. An introduction. Like most of her poems, this poem too is a confessional one. To put it briefly, confessional poetry concentrates on the personal and the realistic experiences of the poets themselves. It voices the poet's inner feelings, so it may be an autobiographical account of the poet. The poet analyses the situation in the light of his or her surroundings and experiences, expressing her own feelings and experiences to unburden the mind from strong emotions. Let's quickly go through the poem while discussing some key points. So, the poem begins with the speaker telling the readers that even though she is not aware of the politics in her country, she can repeat the names of some of the renowned politicians, just like one can repeat the names of weekdays and months. She claims that she is a true Indian, for she is brown and born in Malabar. She also tells that she speaks three languages, English, Hindi and Malayalam, writes in two, English and Malayalam, and dreams in one. The language of dreams can be interpreted as one common for every human being. However, she isn't okay with her friends, cousins and critics, urging her not to write in English language, since English is not her mother tongue. She wants them to leave her alone and mind their own business. She maintains that, the language I speak, becomes mine, with all its distortions and peculiarities. Meaning, once a person speaks a particular language, it becomes the language of the speaker, even though it may have flaws. For the speaker, the English language acts as a medium for her to voice her joys, her longings, her hopes. She feels comfortable in expressing her feelings and emotions in English, just like a crow feels comfortable with cawing and a lion with roaring. For her, it isn't like blind speech, like of trees in storm or of monsoon clouds or of rain or the incoherent mutterings of the blazing funeral pyre. The last image makes a transition into a more personal realm. She narrates how she was married off at an early age, and even though she wasn't beaten by her husband, her body felt beaten down. Then, when she started wearing her brother's shirts and trousers and cut her hair short and ignored the so-called patriarchal definition of womanliness, people asked her to dress in saris. To act more like a girl. Not to do this and not to do that. The speaker provides a catalog of things she wasn't allowed to do. She also goes on to share her experiences with men, how they are like sword in its sheath. She finally arrives at the conclusion that she is the one who must love herself, for she too is an individual, and deserves love, like men, and should not look for love and acceptance anywhere else, but from within. Let us now look into the style and diction of the poem. Style and diction of any writer are the distinctive characteristics in his or her works, leaving a lasting impression on the readers. Style of Kamala Das is strikingly unique and innovative, attracting and holding the attention of readers and conveying her views in a convincing manner. It is simple yet powerful, using language as a vehicle for her thoughts, as an expression for her inner feelings. It is thoroughly independent, not influenced by any Western writers. In this poem too, her vocabulary, idioms, choice of words and some syntactical constructions are part of what has been termed the Indianization of English. Her diction is lyrical, lucid and simple. She becomes successful in building up the various layers of her thoughts and ideas while presenting them to the readers in a clear manner. She knows the immense potential of words for conveying her inner turmoil and the urgency of her emotions. Let us move on to the imagery and symbols. Works of Kamala Das are distinguishable because of rich imagery and symbols used by her, captivating the commotions going on in her mind. She draws these images from everyday life while expressing her passion and feministic feelings. These images function as windows to her heart and soul. They enable her to establish an easier rapport with the readers by depicting the depth of her turmoil, even with a minimum use of words. One of the recurring images used by Kamala Das is that of the human body. Male body represents lust and exploitation, whereas the female body symbolizes submissiveness, suffering and humiliation. It is apparent throughout the poem, for instance, she tells the readers about how she was physically humiliated behind closed doors, but she never got what she always asked for, love. She conveys a sense of disgust for the male's behavior. I hope this class was helpful. If it was, share it with your friends and if you have any doubts or suggestions, leave them in the comments section. Thank you.